Hello everyone, Meg here from PMTVUK, and I'm back with another beautiful acoustic guitar in my hands, and I'm super excited to get into the video for this one. Just before I dive into the video, make sure you hit that subscribe button so you don't miss any new product releases or any exciting videos from Dagan or myself. So very excitingly, I've got in my hands an absolutely stunning 800 series Taylor guitar. As this guitar is at the top of Taylor's range, this is obviously a very high ticket guitar, but for that reason, it's absolutely stunning, and the details on this are just so beautiful. This is going to be a very fun video to get into, and hopefully I can share with you just how gorgeous this sounds through the video. So this is an 814CE. The 814CEs are not new to Taylor. We have one behind us here, and that is the standard 814CE with V-class bracing and rosewood back and sides. This one, however, is a little bit different as it is a builder's edition model. Now, the builder's editions have been around for a few years, and they are all stunning guitars. They range from sort of 300 series all the way up to the top end guitars. Things that make up the builder's edition is a real attention to detail with the luthier work and flourishes that come in it. So lots of unique detailing. As this is an 800 series model though, it's got some of the finest detailing I've seen on a Taylor guitar in a while. It's a high ticket item, but it's got a very rich and full sound. When I've spoken to a lot of people over the years about acoustic guitars, it's often asked of me, how much do you really get when you're paying for a high ticket guitar? What's the difference? Why would you pay for a high end guitar when you could get something that is a lot cheaper? Well, I think when it comes to acoustics, when you do play a guitar of this sort of caliber, I think it really becomes clear in your hands and with the tone, kind of what goes into these more higher end models. There's lots of ornate detailing and carefully selected tone wood pairings that help to bring these guitars to life. And if you do ever get the chance to be a guitar of this sort of level, then I wouldn't be surprised if you can feel that sort of difference yourself. Probably the sort of guitar that I would dream of buying and then be too scared to take out to a gig because it's too beautiful. So the 814CE Builder's Edition, looking at some of the specs of this gorgeous guitar, got an Adirondack spruce top, and this is a very, very light spruce top. In the spruce family, you generally get Sitka spruce, which will be used on most acoustic guitars. Then you can get some Engelmann spruce, which is similar characteristic, and then and a spruce that is used slightly less would be Adirondack. It's got a really pale, light appearance and a beautiful, shining, bright sound to it. This is particularly well chosen to go with that rich and bassy Indian rosewood on the back and sides. This particular Indian rosewood on the back and sides is absolutely stunning. It's got such a gorgeous, rich grain to it, and that really translates in the playing when you hear it. One thing you'll always find with the 814 series is when you play that bass note, it rings out so well. There's so much resonance that comes through, and that is a lot to do with the wood pairings, as well as other factors like the bracing and other woods used for the bridge and things like that. But a lot of it is to do with that gorgeous wood pairing. So that Adirondack spruce top with the Indian rosewood back and sides, exactly what you'd imagine on a guitar this caliber, but it's just melting your ears, sort of rich, powerful and resonant tones coming from this guitar. Of course, inside it's got V-class bracing, which you will find across the Taylor series now. This V-class bracing really helps to give some extra sustain to the harmony and extra resonance. I find when I AB sort of older Taylors, if they ever come into the guitar shop against the newer ones, there's definitely a noticeable lift in the resonance in the acoustic guitars. That will also be playing quite a key role in lifting that gorgeous bassy rosewood with that spruce top and giving it some extra resonance when you're hearing it acoustic. The V-cast bracing inside is used with Sitka spruce, as is the wood used on most acoustic guitar tops. And then looking at some of the other detailings on this guitar, it's got a neotropical mahogany neck, which is again quite widely used on Taylor guitars now. What I love about these guitars is the satin finish you get on the neck. For me, I think it just moves up and down a lot smoother. This is a personal preference. I know a lot of guitar players that do quite like a glossy neck, but this kind of smooth satin finish that they apply to this mahogany neck, it's just got such an ease and playability to it that it really helps you glide up and down the neck. When I was playing it earlier, I didn't want to put this guitar down, and that is definitely to do with the sound, but it's a lot to do with how comfortable the neck feels as well. As you'd imagine, it's got quite a... As you'd imagine, it's not an overly rounded neck profile too, so it doesn't feel too chunky or wide in your hands when you are playing. Taylor's guitars do come strong with a reasonably high string gauge, so a custom 13 to 53, and you'd imagine this to feel quite hard to play, but with that neck and those strings that are coated, it's a really easy and wonderful guitar to play. With that mahogany neck, you also have an ebony fretboard. And another thing that is quite bespoke about these higher end guitars is the natural grains that come on this sort of ebony. When it comes to wood grains, a lot of the time with acoustic guitars, it can be non-preferable to have guitars with those big grains. So people would tend to go for things with quite symmetrical grains, but there's something about that stripe running through the ebony that's really, really gorgeous. And you'll find it too on the standard 814C. Because of the type of ebony they're using, it's got such a lovely natural grain to it. Got a curved wing ebony bridge down here. And if you weren't familiar, Taylor do grow their own ebony, which is something that is fantastic about Taylor. And they'll be harvesting it and using it more sustainably than outsourcing it. So they're able to add these ebony details to these guitars. I know that they're reharvesting and replanting ebony, which will definitely be helping the more sustainable use of ebony. When it comes to the nut width as well, talking about how comfortable that neck is, if you're in the UK, this has got a 44.45mm nut width, or if you are over in the States, then it would have a 1¾-inch nut width. So quite a standard acoustic guitar neck, although slightly wider than your typical 43-44. So looking around 44.5, but again, because of that neck profile, it doesn't feel overly rounded or wide, so it still feels super comfortable to play. And it helps that these guitars come set up like a dream. We're looking at some of the builder's edition detailing that's been added to this guitar that sets it apart from the standard 814C you can see behind me. One of the first things that you'll notice on this guitar that you don't get on this model, something you have on this guitar that you don't have on the standard 814C, is these gold 510 Goto tuners. They've got a vintage look, very antique and vintage looking. With that gold finish and the design as well, they've got a real vintage feel to them. Something that you don't see on a lot of acoustics is an old school Goto tuner, especially in a gold finish. So it's a really nice bespoke feature that's been added to this, and it just helps to tie it all together. The ebony from the fretboard is also used up on the headstock, creating this really symmetrical look all the way up the neck with some mother of pearl inlay and Taylor logo at the top. It's only a subtle design, but it's got a really classy look to it, and I think with that ebony top on the headstock. Looking at the body as well, so something that is quite standard with the 800 and the 900 series guitars is an arm bevel. If you haven't seen an arm bevel before on an acoustic guitar, then this is something that really helps to aid comfortability when you're playing. If you can see from how I'm demonstrating here, your arm tends to rest around this sort of space on an acoustic guitar naturally. So having this here gives you some real support if you are playing. And if you're playing a gig for a long time, then you want to get all of the comfortability and support you can get. If you're doing one of those 2-hour sets, for example, then this would be really nice. But it also just means that if you are sat at home playing and you want to play for a few hours, then you've got some extra support from your guitar. And what you'll see on the standard models behind me is where the back and sides meet the top, you have just a standard join. But this here with the chamfered edges just makes everything a bit smoother to touch and slightly more rounded, which again is just going to make this guitar even more comfortable. On the cutaway too, which is something I would imagine from a builder's edition, there is a bevel on the cutaway too. So if you are playing high up the neck, then if you're reaching down here, for example, then you have this comfortable space here to rest your arm. With that high gloss lacquer finish as well, it all just feels very smooth and comfortable. Some other small details of this particular guitar. You've got a black tusk nut at the top and a white micarta saddle down here. The mother of pearl inlay I mentioned up on the headstock, which is synonymous with the 800 series, also runs up the fretboard, as you'd imagine, with that really simple but sleek looking design. Around the sound hole, there is a green abalone rosette and you also have a rosewood pickguard. I think the pickguards on the 800 series models are my favorite pickguards that you have across the whole of the Taylor series. I think the pickguards on the 800 series models are always my favorite. The rosewood pickguard is so rich looking and it's got a natural stripe to it because of the grains of rosewood, as you'd imagine. And lastly, this guitar, of course, does come fitted with Taylor's ES2 pickup system. So you can plug this in and play it at a gig through a PA system, through an acoustic amp, or however you wish to use it for recording. As it is Taylor's sensitive pickup system and this is a naturally bassy guitar, then you're going to find you're going to get some really good tones from this plugged in. With the pickup system, you of course have bass, treble and main volume, as well as inside a very handy phase switch, which if you ever encounter issues with gigging and not quite being able to EQ your guitar at a venue, then that phase switch inside can really help to knock out some of those more nasty frequencies. Something I didn't know when I first got a Taylor, and it was really handy once I found out about it at gigs. So something to note there, if you are ever playing with a guitar as resonant and full sounding as this one, then you may need to use that phase switch inside. Of course, this guitar does come fitted with a deluxe Taylor hard case, so you can keep it safe from all of the elements and carry it around in style, just as you'd want to. These guitars have a gloss finish on them, which will help to protect them. But the nature of an acoustic of this sort of caliber, you will want to, of course, look after it. Guitar that we need to know, and a brief chat on builder's editions in general. And I think a real credit to Andy Powers, who is the designer of these guitars. He's doing a fantastic job at creating innovative and exciting new acoustic guitars with unique features and really fresh and exciting guitars to play. Of course, as well, they have gorgeous tone and that super comfortable playability that you'd imagine from a guitar of this kind. Do let me know in the comment section what you think of how this guitar sounds and how it looks. What do you think about the 800 series models, and are you a fan of playing these more bespoke and higher end acoustic guitars? Do let me know, I would love to hear your thoughts. Thanks so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have, make sure you hit that like button and subscribe to the channel. You can also come find us over on socials at Play Music Today, where you can give us a follow. I've been Meg and I will see you all in a video very soon.